Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Feast School. And today, we will be talking about how you can work in a team, how teams can collaborate with each other, how you can influence your team to be better, and how you can be a part of something greater in a team of people, whether it's a company, whether it's a group, a club, whatever it is. Feast School, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Luke Talks, bros. Okay, so the first point that is important when being in a team, and this is probably the most important idea, but it's listening. Now, listening can branch out into so many different ways you can listen to your team members when they have ideas. You're gonna wanna show that you care about their ideas. This will make people want to work with you more. And it's important to listen to other people's ideas when you're in a team, because maybe they can think of stuff you can't. Maybe you can think of stuff they can't. But that's really important to listen to their perspective and how they feel or how they think the project would be better with their ideas. It also shows you care sincerely about their ideas and their input on the project, or whatever the group is working on. It's really important to listen when there's important information. When there's a problem, sometimes things can get heated up, and Steve Jobs made a quote, and it goes a little like this, but it's relevant to teamwork. Now, the quote is, well, it's a story that I'm quoting, but he did yard work when he was a kid, and he had these rocks. And he told him to put them in this machine. And he said, come back tomorrow. So he came back the next day. And what came out of the machine after the rocks were in the machine bouncing off each other was these great gems and these cool looking rocks. So that's a metaphor for teamwork, because if you want to work in the team, sometimes things are going to get heated. People have different views and ideas, but in the end, you can make something great. It's important to read facial expressions, seeing if they're interested. If they're looking at their watch, looking at the time, they're probably getting bored. Or this goes for any reading when you're selling something, but we're talking about teamwork, so if they're looking bored, maybe we need to think of a new approach for the project. If they're upset or happy, it's important to communicate about that. Okay, part two, or point two, tip two, is doing the hard thing. Now, it's gonna be really hard when you're working a group project trying to create something, but if you work hard on a project with the team, it shows you care, you'll be invited back to more group projects, and it will ultimately help the community grow. You may think you're just doing your job and putting a little effort into it, but if you really contribute and put your needed skill set into what they're doing, go above and beyond even, that can improve the whole scale of what everyone's working on. Now, doing the hard thing can also involve problem people. And sometimes you're gonna have to leave people behind if they're causing problems in your group or company or whatever. For example, if someone doesn't really care about the project, shows up maybe intoxicated or bored or just not at their ultimate peak, sometimes you're gonna have to make the decision to let them go, because it's contagious and it can lead into other people and how they feel about the project. It's also important not to hire too fast or bring people into the project too fast, because you have to get to know what their skill set, what their role, and even if they're workable with the group you're working in. So don't bring people into your group too fast without really much thought. It can seem really exciting when you do this, like, oh, I met this person, we're gonna work well together. But you gotta make sure that this person fits well with your group. Okay, point three. There are different type of team members you can work with. Well, there's three general team members I'm gonna bring up today, but it's essential when starting a group. So the first person that is essential in a group is the logical thinker. Now the logical thinker is really good at numbers. He's good at organization, organizing how things should be and scheduling when people should work. He's good at reading generally. He's good at numbers and figuring out what works well when creating this project. So logical thinkers are important. But you can't just have a bunch of logical thinkers. You also have to have the emotional thinker. Now the emotional thinker is someone who's good at networking, good at social surroundings, someone who's good with people and creative projects, the creative side of things. The emotional thinker and the logical thinker can work really, really well together, but they can work bad together too. They can go at each other with their different views a lot of the time, which is brings me to my third type of worker, the moderator. Now the moderator is obviously, what the name, good at moderating the people in the group. They're good with conflict, dealing with people who may be unhappy, and they're also good with people. But having these three essential team members in your group is essential. Now, fourth point and last point, communication. Make sure you have a clear message of what you're saying. So if you're talking about, it doesn't matter. When you're in a group and you say, and let's say you're building a bridge and you need this 50-foot beam for the bridge, and the boss isn't really good at communicating, so he says, build this bridge, writes down the number sloppy, just gives it to the guy. That's not good on the sender's part of the communication, because what if he doesn't read the 5 as a 6 and accidentally does 60, makes it beam too high, that can mess up the whole project. So make sure the message the sender sends is clear and understanding, and make sure the receiver of what the person receiving the message is understanding what the sender is saying. So all three have to be good. The sender has to make a clear message that the receiver can understand. Consistency is another great part of communication. So let's say you have a meeting and you have all these plans, but it's a big project and you have a lot of to-dos on your paper that you made for this project, right? And you have a meeting and you plan everything and everyone has got their own little job. Well, consistency with communication is important, because if you don't really communicate on the project consistently, the idea can die off and it won't be come out into reality as much as it could have. So stay up to date with the team and what they're trying to say, and make sure they're getting the things done. And yeah, those are the 4 points of communicating that I wrote down. Really important. Listening, doing the hard things, the different type of thinkers, the emotional, logical, and moderator, and the communicating. These are important 4 steps when creating or just being in a group in general. Thank you for watching this episode of Peace School. You guys have a great day. Welcome back to another episode of Luke Talks, bros.